Hi everyone, my name is Peven and I'm a physiotherapist from SingHealth Community Hospitals.
Hi Peven, after I get a stroke, what are my chances for full recovery?
So the rate of recovery actually differs from patient to patient. There are certain factors that can affect the rate of recovery, and some of them include these but are not limited to the age of the patient, location and severity of the stroke, their past medical history and cognitive function.
So can you tell me what's the difference between a PT, OT and an ST?
So a PT is actually, like myself, a physiotherapist. So what we do is we help to regain the patient's overall mobility from getting out of bed all the way to navigating through obstacles. We also work on their lower limb strength and their balance to help them regain their function. And as for the OT part, I'd like to introduce my colleague, Charissa.
Hi there, everyone. My name is Charissa. I'm an occupational therapist from SingHealth Community Hospitals. I hear that you guys want to know more what OTs do, short for occupational therapists. So what we do is we actually help individuals to regain independence in their daily activities of living, such as bathing or dressing or brushing their teeth. So we do practice with them to regain independence in, you know, those tasks. What we do as well, upper exercises training to regain arm or hand function and usage in their daily activities. We also do cognitive training such as attention training or problem solving skills training. We also do help individuals to transit back to, you know, home and community roles such as return to work or, you know, being able to engage in a leisure activity such as playing badminton.
And not forgetting our STs, also known as our speech therapists. So post a stroke, we can expect patients to have difficulties in communicating or even swallowing. So when our STs actually determine that our patients do have such difficulties, they can come up with strengthening exercises to help improve the patient's swallowing, and they may also adjust the thickness of a fluid so that our patients don't choke.
So our beloved speech therapists as well look at communication challenges that our post-stroke individuals face. You know, so for some of them, you know, they have difficulties expressing themselves or actually even understanding others. So they do lots of speech training so that they can, you know, communicate with the ones around them.
I see. So must stroke patients take the stroke medication forever?
Yes. Generally, but there are special circumstances where one may need to stop, but you know, all these are advices from the medical doctors.
Then does stroke mean that I'll get dementia quicker or earlier?
So that's actually a good question. Having a stroke does not mean that a patient will get dementia. However, in Singapore, nearly half of our dementia patients have suffered some form of stroke. This stroke-related dementia is actually known as vascular dementia. And the risk for vascular dementia can actually be controlled by having good lifestyle habits to keep your diabetes or high cholesterol in control.
Is it possible to get another stroke?
So one once has a stroke, the risk of getting another one is much higher, but then lifestyle modifications does greatly reduce the risk of having a recurrent stroke.
Last question, is rehab a must to recover from stroke?
Yes, rehab is actually very crucial post a stroke. We'll do continuous and repetitive practice to help rebuild all the lost connections in the brain, which can help our patients to regain their function.